This morning on Press Pass, the city of Youngstown is preparing for a change in leadership as work continues to transform the downtown into an entertainment district. Revitalization is showing no signs of slowing down under the guidance of Mayor John McNally. And in just a few weeks, voters will decide on his successor. So joining us this morning to talk about it all is Mayor McNally. Thank you so much, Mayor, for coming in. And I want to give you just a moment to kind of reflect on what happened in Girard. You say you were in touch with the mayor this morning.
Yeah, I just wanted to extend the city's personal condolences to the city of Girard, to Officer Leo's family. I spoke with Mayor Melfi on the way down just to offer up the city's assistance in any way that we can provide over the next week or so and in the future. I saw earlier Mayor Melfi in the clip, and he's certainly very emotional. It's probably the worst thing that you will have to deal with as mayor of a city, getting a phone call like Mayor Melfi got last night. But again, our condolences to the entire city of Girard as they move forward this week.
Absolutely. Our hearts just break this morning, and such a young life lost. I want to talk about the city of Youngstown, though, because we are seeing some progress here. We want to touch on that before you leave office. Mm-hmm. You have a lot of experience as mayor now, and everyone sees the work that's being done. I see it every morning when I park. The amphitheater is going to be built soon, and we've got restaurants coming into downtown. What's the latest on those developments, and do you see those really progressing and flourishing?
Yeah, I mean, everything that I've seen in the news in the past couple weeks and what we've been working on in the past 3.5 years continues to move forward. This week we began the process of purchasing the old St. Vincent de Paul building. We're going to either try to sell that or help develop that site as part of the development of the amphitheater project. The 84 inch sewer line site that's on that site will be go out to bid in November. Okay. That's work that has to be done before the amphitheater can be constructed. We're purchasing a few last parcels of property from the railroads over there as well. So that project's moving forward. Obviously great developments like the Whistling Keg, which opened up downtown here in the past week. That continues forward. The hotel project continues forward.
Yeah, we were wondering about that because there is an investigation, but you do know that's moving smoothly.
That's moving forward, and we expect that project, hopefully a certificate of occupancy for the hotel by the end of the year, and hopefully a full opening, I think, sometime in late February, early March.
Well, it's going to be exciting to see that building. I'm sure it's come a long way. You know, they always say, if you build it, they will come. That's my favorite movie, Field of Dreams. Do you really think that this is the rebirth of downtown Youngstown?
Well, I always give credit to previous mayors because a lot of the decisions that were made by Pat Ungaro and George McKelvey and Jay Williams have led to the developments where we're at today. Obviously, the Covelli Center helped spark this. But even the decisions of Mayor Ungaro and City Council made in the late 80s and early 90s about which properties to take ownership, to take time to create the downtown CIC that could take ownership of these buildings and get them into other hands that could develop the properties. We've had a lot of great things happen in downtown in the past 3.5 years. But they're the result of a lot of decisions people made before us. We've just built on them, and I expect the next mayor to do the same.
Okay, what grade would you give yourself? If you're looking back, I'm sure you're kind of thinking about the past. How do you think you've done as mayor?
Well, I'm not going to give myself a grade, but I do know that we've done a lot of the things that we said we were going to do when I got elected. We've reduced crime. We've taken a ton of guns off the street through our Youngstown Police Department. We've done a lot of great infrastructure work, road improvements all across the city, in our neighborhoods, Wick Avenue, Meridian Road. A lot of our major streets have seen substantial improvements.
Obviously
the continued development of the Covelli Center, the development of the amphitheater project. I think we've done what we said. I think we've opened up City Hall, 5 minutes with the mayor, our mayor's weekly spotlight, talking about things that are happening in our community. Mm-hmm. I'm very proud of the work that we've done over the past 3.5 years, and I expect and hope that the next mayor will continue to build on the work that we've done over the past 3.5 years.
Yeah, I mean, the amphitheater project moving forward, that's probably a sign of success as you move forward.
Yes.
So, you know, I'm wondering, as you look at the next mayoral race, some issues have come up in the news. The Vindicator reported on some budget constraints. You're facing a possible deficit, and I know that the auditor mentioned in this article that it's possible you could see some layoffs. Do you think the layoffs are something that could very well happen?
Well, it's certainly a possibility that could happen. A couple months ago when we were talking about some reductions in overtime in the fire department, City Council indicated they really wanted to take a look at the budget towards the end of this year and make some budget priorities into next year. And so we pretty much have decided that we'll finish this year with a balanced budget, and next year's council and next year's mayor can then really start to look at things and determine where their cuts might have to be made. Our finance director earlier this week met with city council and outlined for them where he thinks reductions might be necessary. If you can't do them through attrition, you have to do them through layoffs. But I think that's probably still up in the air, and it probably just depends on what the budget looks after it's completely adjusted at the end of the year, and you look at the money that hasn't been spent and where you can sort of move it around to fix things up. But I think that's something that this council wants to deal with next year as they set their priorities for 2018.
So what will you do? You're moving on. So what are your future plans?
Actually, I can safely say as of today, I don't have any plans, but that's something that's started quietly behind the scenes. I do have to find some work. My wife a couple weeks ago said, what are we doing on January 1st? And I said, well, I'm going to be watching football games. That wasn't really what she wanted to hear.
No, she probably wanted a more concrete answer.
She wanted something a little more concrete, but that's started, but I don't have anything definitely set right now.
All right. Well, I know you're probably looking at a few opportunities, maybe staying within, you know, your expertise in the law. Is that something you might
either want? Law or public service in some respect. I think that's what I'm best at, and I look forward to doing something like that in the future.
Well, I appreciate your time today. Hey, you know what? When one door closes, another one opens. It's happened every time in my life, so I really appreciate your time today. Best of luck to you.
All right. Thank you, Lindsay.
All right. Thank you so much for coming in.